Well, praise the Lord, everybody. How many of you are glad to be here this morning? Would you stand with me, please? We're going to go ahead and get started. Let me say, first off, Happy Mother's Day to all of the ladies and the mothers-to-be. Come on, men, give them a great big... We love our mothers, which would be our wives, and our mothers, too. Amen. Yeah. I want all the men, if your wife is sitting right beside you, I want you to look right in the eye and say, hey, baby, hey, baby. I sure am blessed because you straightened out a mess.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, give her a little kiss and wish her a happy Mother's Day. Amen. You say, we're not supposed to kiss in church. Well, you kissed when you got married in church. Come on. Amen. If you kiss more in church, amen. I'll save that for another sermon. Praise God. We're so glad you're here. I'm sure there'll be some more joining us in just a few minutes, late risers to church, but we're glad if you're a visitor. God bless you for being here. Glad to have Sister Reva's sister in service with us today. Come on, give her a great big God bless you. And then our friends in the back, God bless you. In front of Sister Paula, God bless you for being here. And if you didn't fill out a visitor card, please do before you leave service so we can at least call you and say thank you for coming. And amen. How many of y'all ready to get your praise on this morning? How many of y'all going to get in this river with me one more time? Come on, somebody get out here and get in the river with me. Amen. Y'all come on, get in the river. Y'all remember how we did it in revival. Come on, if you want to get in the river and swim, you remember what the current does. It makes you move. Amen. And so when you love Jesus, you just get in the current and just let the Holy Ghost move you. Amen. Praise God. Come on, let's worship the Lord. Living water, a fountain that never will run dry. How many of y'all got some living water? It's an open heaven we're releasing, and we will never be denied. How many of y'all believe that today? Come on. Cause we're stirring up deep, deep well, stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in the river, we're gonna dance in the river. Cause we're stirring up deep, deep well, stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in the river, we're gonna jump in the river. Come on. Deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out. We cry out, we cry out to you, Jesus. Come on, do that one more time. Deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out. We cry out to you, Jesus. Oh, come on, I've got a river. Well, I've got a river of living water, a fountain that never will run. If you got Jesus on the inside, let me hear you give him a shout. It's an open heaven. We're releasing, we will never be denied. Come on, everybody, help me sing it. Cause we're stirring up deep, deep well, stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in this river. Come on, dance in the river. Cause I'm stirring up deep, deep well, we'll stirring up deep, deep waters. I'm gonna jump in the river, I'm gonna jump in the river. Oh, I said deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out. We cry out to you, Jesus, one more time. Oh, I said deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out. We cry out, I'm crying out to you, Jesus. Come on, we're falling now. I'm falling into deeper waters. I said, how many of y'all gonna help me now? Are y'all awake yet? Y'all, come on, y'all came to give God some praise? What'd y'all come to do? Come on, Pastor Cody, get in the river with these kids. Show them what to do, Pastor Cody. Y'all ready? Y'all gonna help me now? Listen now. If God goes to the left,
we're gonna go to the left.
If God goes to the right,
we're gonna go to the right.
I'm gonna jump, 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 jump. I'm gonna jump, 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 jump. Everybody, if God goes to the left,
we're gonna go to the left.
If God goes to the right,
we're gonna go to the right.
I'm gonna dance, 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 dance. I'm gonna dance, dance. Come on, everybody. If God goes to the left, if God goes to the right, I'm gonna shout. I'm gonna shout. Come on. If God goes to the left, if God goes to the right, I'm gonna jump, 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 jump. Come on, everybody. Jump, jump. Oh, I said. One more time, come on. I said, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out, deep cries out. We cry out to you, Jesus. Oh, come on, give God a praise in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be praised. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, if God goes to the left, if God goes to the right,
go to the right.
I'm going to jump, 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 jump.
Jump in the river.
Jump, jump.
Jump, jump, everybody.
If God goes to the left,
we're going to go to the left.
If God goes to the right,
go to the right.
I'm going to dance, 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 dance. I'm gonna dance, dance, dance. Come on, help me. If God goes to the left, if God goes to the right, I'm gonna shout. I'm gonna shout. If God goes to the left, if God goes to the right, I'm gonna dance, dance, jump, shout. Come on, everybody. Deep cries out. We cry out, we cry out to you, Jesus. Oh, I said, he cried out, he cried out, he cried out, he cried out. We cry out, we cry out to you, Jesus, because you're worthy, Lord of our praise. Oh, I said, he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, give God a praise in the house of the Lord this morning. You know, we're honoring our mothers today. And moms, this is a day that we're taking this day just to tell you how much we love and appreciate you. Motherhood's hard. You know what? As your husband and as the children, we rally around you. We're going to make sure that we keep chains broken off of you. How many of you men understand you would still be wearing camouflage and eating with your fingers if you'd never gotten married? Some of y'all are saying that wouldn't be a bad idea because you had to learn how to put something else on beside camouflage and use a fork and a knife. But I'm glad my wife pulled me and she called me up. Amen. I'm a better man today than I was 29 years ago. That was a weak amen from the men. Let me try the ladies. Ladies, how many of you know that your man is a better man all the years y'all been married than when you first found him? That's what I thought. Come on, lift your hands and let's give God a praise. Father, we love you this morning. You're worthy to receive our praise. We ask your Holy Spirit that you move in a way that brings glory and honor to the Lord Jesus. Have this service. You're in control. And And we thank you for all that you've already accomplished and all what you're going to do. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. This power, in the name of Jesus. Come on, help me sing it, everybody. In the name of the Lord. There is power in the name of Jesus. And all hell trembles at that name. There is power
in the name of Jesus.
Come on, make hell shake this morning.
There is power.
Shake hell. Spirit, oh. Anybody want to be full of God? Fill me up. One more time. Fill me. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. With your glory, Lord. With your power, Lord. With your mercy, Lord. Fill me up. Fill me up, Lord. Fill me up. That the world may see me. Hallelujah. Full of glory. Full of Jesus in the world. Let the redeemed of the Lord. Send revival, God. Send revival, God. Send revival. Fill me. I can fill somebody else up, Lord. I can share the love. Let me overflow. I want people to see a difference in my life. I want to be different today, God, than I was yesterday. Fill me up. One more time. Fill me up. Fill me more of your love, your compassion. One more time. Fill me. I need you. I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord. Hallelujah. Because there's power in the name of Jesus. When you're full, amen. There's power in the name of my Lord and my Savior Jesus. Come on, praise him. I said the power in the name. And he wants to do. He breaks every chain. Every chain. When you're full, you can walk in his authority. He breaks every chain. He breaks every chain. He breaks every chain.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
He'll set you free.
To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus.
I believe there's power. I know there is
power. There is power in the name of Jesus.
When I call on my name, it saved me.
There is power.
Liberated, your eyes have been opened and the liberty is free today. Give God a praise in the house of the Lord if you know that there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There's power. By the neck and tell them you don't have to stay bound today. You don't have to stay bound today. Tell your neighbor you don't have to stay bound. You don't have to stay bound. You can get set free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You don't have to go back to it. You can stay free in the name of Jesus through the power of the Spirit of the living God. Can I have an amen? Can I have a good amen? Amen? Praise God. Give the Lord a clap offering of praise this morning. God is a good God, isn't he? Amen. We have a very special day planned for y'all today. And right now, some of our children are going to come. And they're going to do something special for the mothers. And I'm going to take this right here and get this set up for them, because we love our children.
Mother's Day. On this Mother's Day, go Bailey!
I really believe he just naturally gravitates toward the microphone. Amen. Just in case he's got an announcement for the WMs. Amen.
We have a great bunch of kids, don't we? And to get a great bunch of kids, we have to have a great bunch of moms.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
And I want to take just a few minutes and let y'all know that moms are not just the person that gave birth to you. I've been coming to this church for over 10 years now, and we have a great bunch of ladies that have so much to offer and so much that they give of themselves. There have been so many ladies over these past 10 years that have made such a difference in my life, not in helping me to develop who God wants me to be, who have been there when I've had tears to shed, who have been there when we've had successes to cheer me on. And they are just wonderful ladies all throughout the church. And so, like I said, they're just so willing to give and to pour themselves out to other people. And even Miss Pam in our nursery, my boys, they love her every bit as much as they love me. She's a wonderful lady. You don't have to have given birth. You don't have to have given birth to be a mom, to be a supporter, to give a hug. We have everybody, ladies all over here. And when you're involved and a part of something as special as what we have here, you're a part of a family. Tomorrow night, we ladies get to be treated. Woo-hoo! We don't have to cook. We don't have to clean. We don't have to serve. Our men are going to do that for us tomorrow night. Woo-hoo! I have not been told a menu yet. I am promised that it will be divine, and if they know what good for them, it will be, right? But you don't have to have come to one of our women's meetings in the past. You don't have to have been a part of it or gone on conference or gone on outings. Just come. If you're a lady, come and sit and enjoy. Get to know some of these other ladies around here. I promise it's going to make a difference in your life. It's going to help you to feel at home here, because what's more at home than a mama's hug or a mama's smile? But y'all come on out tomorrow night at 6:30. We're going to be in the fellowship hall, just going to get to enjoy and socialize and have a good time. And we don't have to worry about a thing, because the men are going to do it all. But here, I'm going to turn it back over to Pastor, and I just encourage y'all to come out and meet some of the ladies and just get on a more in-depth personal touch. I'm telling you, it will change your world. Whether you know it that night or whether you see it 2 years down the line, when you see what that lady said, it still makes a difference to you that day. And I can give you an example after example of so many different ladies over the time here at Faith that have just touched me. And I thank you all for being that to me, to the younger girls, or even I've had girls younger than me that have said something that has made a difference. So never doubt that you can't make a difference. And I also want all the ladies, after you leave, mom or not, all the ladies, there's a special gift for you out on the foyer table. Just please pick it up on your way out.
Amen. We do have the finest ladies God ever put on the planet called Earth. Beautiful. They make the whole world smell better. Some of you men, you ought to just walk behind some of the ladies here. Get behind Paula and Ginger, and Courtney's even smelling up Casey. They just smell the place up something good. I'm telling you, it's like walking through a garden, all the different perfumes and aromas. Ladies, keep wearing the perfume, amen. We may complain about how much it costs, but you make the world smell better, amen. And tomorrow night, the men will be serving the ladies, and we will, listen, we bought the best hot dogs Walmart has to offer. Hallelujah. We're going to cut some in half. We're going to fry them, wrap them around some bologna. Nothing better than a fried bologna hot dog sandwich. We're going to grill some. We're going to deep fry some. Hallelujah.
How many of you ladies would just come and eat a hot dog as long as the men are serving you and waiting on you hand and foot? You say jump, we jump. You say hot dog, we get hot dog. You say tea, we get tea. You got one day, ladies, to make this a special day. Don't blow it. Don't blow it. We love you. We're going to take care of you tomorrow night. Amen. Amen. Stand with me. We're going to get ready to receive our Sunday morning tithe and offering. And I know some of the songs that we did during the revival, we're doing them again, but we've got new stuff always in on the shelf being learned, but we're going to do one. Some, I don't know what it is about this song. People just love this song. They love to lift their hand in the sanctuary. How many of you came to give God your offering this morning? How many of you came to give God your tithe? Let me get this microphone in here. Any other day, I would say it must be a woman. But today, I'm not going to do that because I'm on my best behavior today. I'm on my best behavior today. Amen. Father, we love you. I'm thankful that we can come and bring our tithe and offering into the storehouse. This is where we have our spiritual needs met. This is where our broken hearts are mended. This is where our troubled minds are put to ease. This is where miracles happen for us, signs and wonders, the teaching of the word, the maturing. All of it happens right here at Faith Assembly. This is the storehouse. Our children grow up here. They're baptized. They're married. Father, through the whole process, you've instituted the church, the house of God, to be the meeting place, the dwelling place where you release your glory and you change us and mature us to leave this place to go to a world to introduce the world to Jesus. And today I'm glad to bring back just the portion, the tithe, the tenth of my offering, my paycheck, to bring it back to your house. And I ask you, mighty God, that you receive all the glory and let you open the windows of heaven over my life and bless me in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said amen. All right, come on, bring your offering, everybody. Praise God. When y'all come on Mother's Day, nothing, we're here to have church. Mom, come on, all you ladies, show the men how to get it going on this morning. Come on, can't you feel that groove? Can't you feel the soul in it? Come on, Brother Ricky, help me out here. Show them what to do, Sister Jan. Come on, y'all help me now. Here we go. One, two, three. I'm lifting my hand in the sanctuary. Lift my hand in the sanctuary. I'm blessing the Lord. He's worthy. Oh, yes, I am blessing the Lord. I'm going to lift my hand in the sanctuary. Lift my hand in the sanctuary. Blessing the Lord. Come on, y'all got any joy this morning? Come on. I declare joy in the Holy Ghost. I got some joy in the Holy Ghost. I got some joy, 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 unspeakable and full of glory. I declare joy in the Holy Ghost. I declare joy in the Holy Ghost. I declare joy, joy, joy. Now come on, everybody give me a Shabbat in the house of God. Help me sing it one more time. And bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. I declare joy. I declare joy in the Holy Ghost. I declare joy in the Holy Ghost. I declare joy, joy, joy. Come on, give God a praise in the house of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Faith Assembly, not your normal church. We like to get our praise on. We like to shake it up just a little bit and give God some praise. He's been too good to me for me not to praise him. How can I sit still and know that I'm breathing today? Because the breath he gave me, I couldn't catch it in a fast car. Amen. I'm eating good. I'm dressing good. You know why I dress good, don't you? Because my wife says, you're not leaving the house looking like that. And sometimes I got a pink jacket and purple pants and white shoes, and I think I look like Superfly. I'm feeling good. She says, you're not going out looking like that. Amen. You can be seated in the presence of the Lord. God bless you. How many mothers are excited? This is Mother's Day. Men, let me ask you a question. How many men actually went out and shopped for the Mother's Day? Amen. I did too. See, I've learned to listen a little better. And when a lady says, ooh, I like that, that usually means find a way to get it without her knowing. And I'm getting better at that. And so we want to tell to Dana and to all of the mothers and the mothers-to-be how much we love and appreciate y'all. Men, one more time, look at your wife and say, hey, baby, I'm blessed to have you in my life. I didn't hear that at all, ladies. Did you hear that? I didn't hear that. Look at your, hey, I'll tell you what. Say it like you did the first time you saw her. When you see them from across the distance, you holler. You don't holler. Hey, when I saw Dana, when we met up the last time, it was like, hey! Girl, you look good. And 29 years later, she's still making me scream and holler. Amen. Amen. I believe it. I believe it. I preach it. Say sweet things to your wife. She'll say sweet things back to you. Amen. Amen. If you have your Bible, I want you to join me. And we have some mugs out here on the back for all of the ladies, Sister Ginger and Sister Paula and some of the other ladies. I'm not sure who all did that, but they've got some mugs back here in the back for you. All of the, I guess the women, I don't guess it's just for the mothers, is it? Is it for all the ladies? Amen. Are they feminine? Because if we have any left, can I get me one? Amen. Amen. But we just want to say that we love you and we honor you and we want you to have a good, good day. And this is your day, Mom. This is the day that you have control over the remote control. This is the day that you get the chair, the couch, TV. The kids, they're gone somewhere else. I'm just down to one. And But even when they're all over there, it's not bad. Amen. So this is your day. Judges chapter 4, if you have your Bible. And I'm not going to keep you very long. That's what Elizabeth Taylor told her seventh husband. Not going to keep you very long. But we'll get you out of here. How many men have already planned to take your wife out to dinner? I have. I know better not to even ask my wife to cook on Mother's Day. Amen. This is her day. Because you know how it goes. If I give her this day, I might get tomorrow. And I always need tomorrow. Amen. And next month is our month, men. So sow a seed today. Amen. Judges chapter 4, if you'll stand for the reading of the Word of God. Here we go. Judges chapter 4, verse 4. Israel's leader at that time, the one who was responsible for bringing the people back to God, was Deborah, a prophetess, the wife of Lapidoth. She held court at a place now called Deborah's Palm Tree, between Ramah and Bethel in the hill country of Ephraim, and the Israelites came to her to decide their disputes. One day she summoned Barak, son of Abinoam, who lived in Kadesh in the land of Naphtali, and said to him, "The Lord God of Israel has commanded you to mobilize 10,000 men from the tribes of Naphtali and Zebulun. Lead them to Mount Tabor to fight King Jabin's mighty army with all his chariots under General Sisera's command. The Lord says, I will draw them to the Kishon River, and you will defeat them there. I'll go." Now, notice what this man says. He's breaking every Jewish custom by saying this to a woman. "I'll go, but only if you go with me," Barak said to her. Would you say amen? I want you to look at your wife one more time, and you sons, look at your mother and say, "Mom, honey, today's your day. You got it all together." That's what I want to share for just about 30 minutes, 45 an hour, whatever, 20, 15, 10. Wow. I'm closing. Father, add your anointing to this word. Let it be a fun day. Let us honor the women respectfully today. This is their day, and I dedicate this word to them. In Jesus' name, and everyone said amen. I read about a woman who telephoned a friend, and the phone rang, and she said, well, how you doing? And the friend on the other end said, I feel horrible. She said, my head is killing me. The house is a mess. The kids are driving me crazy. Well, okay. He said, the kids are driving me crazy. And so the caller said, very sympathetically, she said, now listen, you go lay down. I'm going to come over. How much laundry have you got? She said, about 15 loads. She said, you go lay down. I'm going to come over to your house. I'm going to clean the house. I'm going to wash all the clothes. I'm going to fold the clothes. I'm going to vacuum the floor, wash all the dishes. I'm going to cook supper for you, and I'm going to watch the kids. You just go lay down and you rest. Take it easy. And she said, I'd love to thank you. When you coming? I'll be there in just a few minutes. She said, and by the way, how's Sam doing? She said, Sam? She said, I don't have a husband named Sam. She said, oh, I'm sorry. I must have called the wrong number. There was a long pause, and the lady said, well, are you still coming over? Someone said a mother is God's deputy on the earth. How many of y'all believe that? God, a woman is God's deputy. We call them in the church popo, the church police. That means when some of the kids are going crazy, any mother in here, they reserve the right to say to any child, and without you getting your feelings hurt, and you getting upset and bent out of shape and want to quit the church, any woman in here, and we've raised our children that way. If you saw my children running or throwing rocks or whatever, you could tell them, hey, stop that, put that rock down, don't run out in front of that car, you know. because my children were able to susceptible to do that. And so, you know, a mother has got a deputy on the earth. Billy Graham said, let your home be your parish, your little brood, your congregation, your living room, a sanctuary, and your knee, a sacred altar. You see, the most difficult thing about saying all of this is that so many moms are looking around for role models today. And it's hard for mothers, young mothers, to find a role model anymore. It's like society has diminished the role of the stay-at-home mother and motherhood in general, that you're not supposed to be able to enjoy raising your children. You're not supposed to enjoy being happily married. And, you know, you still got to play some on the side. And I'm thankful that my home is a peaceful home. I'm thankful my home is a happy home. 99% of the time, it's happy. You always have that time where the kids go crazy or the husband does something stupid or the wife burns the meal and you have to call the fire department. But you survive those days. Amen. And it's still a good day. You get a little more paint, paint the wall. Amen. And the most difficult thing is that moms are looking to see who can fit such a high standard, because moms are busy people. They got so many things going today. They've got the children. God bless you, mama, for taking care of the children, because if taking the children, most fathers have nothing to do with their children unless it involves four-wheelers and rifles and shotguns and camouflage. Let them get a good runny nose and get a fever and earache. And, you know, most moms have one child. A lot of them have more than one child. And then they've got to work. And moms today feel frustrated. They're exasperated. Who can help me when I don't have anybody to give me any help? They feel guilty from juggling the role of they're the star of Mission Impossible. They feel so like a failure because they're not with their children all the time. Moms are having to take their children, drop them off at a daycare, go to work, and by the time you pay the daycare, you barely have anything left over just to put food on the table. And moms, you know, I think moms today, younger moms, need a word of encouragement from the pulpit to the pew. Moms need a word of encouragement from an older generation, from older ladies who knew how to, you know, become successful. You moms that have raised your kids up into teenagers and you haven't killed anybody yet, not that we know of anyway. You haven't made the news yet, so you're doing a good job if you haven't killed your teenagers by now. But you need to hear a word of encouragement from the older generation rather than hearing a lecture on how to do this and how to do that. I've heard some women tell mothers with children, well, you know what? If that was my child, this is what I'd do. And they don't have any children. You don't know what you'll do till you get some. Get you four or five of these kids, amen. Then we'll see how well you maintain your cool. And you need a kind word. Amen. It's like the young lady. She moved into the neighborhood across the street from an older couple. And one day the young lady went out with the laundry to hang them up on the clothesline. For you young people that don't know what a clothesline is, this is before the day of washer and dryer. You know, you washed them like Wodey did and Mama Dane did. And even when I was growing up, you know, you washed them outside. But then we got a washing machine, but we didn't have a dryer. So you wash them, you take them outside, and you pin them up with the clothespin, and you hang them out to dry. And before that day, and this young lady, she took her clothes out to the clothesline, and she hung them up. And the older lady across the street looked at her husband and said, you know, she's not learned how to wash clothes very good. Somebody ought to go over there and tell her how to get her clothes clean. They're very dull. And so that, you know, happened that day. The old man didn't say anything. So a couple of days later, the young mother goes back out to the clothesline again. She hangs her clothes out. And the mother said from across the street, the older lady said, you know, somebody really needs to tell her how to brighten her clothes. They're just dull. They're gray. And somebody needs to tell her how to get her clothes clean. The old man didn't say anything. And so about the third time she went out there, a couple of days later, finally the young mother walks out and she's hanging her clothes up on the clothesline. And the older lady across the street says, well, praise God. She's finally learned how to wash clothes and to get her clothes clean. I wonder what she did. The old man put his newspaper down, said, she didn't do anything. I finally cleaned the screens off of our window. Sometimes mothers just need a word of encouragement instead of a lecture. They need the support and admiration of their husband, their support and their admiration of their peers. See, God loves you, Mom. God loves you, mothers. I know it's a special sermon, but come on, you ladies ought to help me preach anyway, because I promise you next month when I'm preaching for the men, ooh, we're going to hoop it up. So you ladies, come on, you're missing your point now. God loves you, mothers. You know why? Because you're his children too. You know, because think about it. God has to love you. God has to favor you because you survived the diaper stage, the terrible twos, the flu, teething. Teething. Glory. Here, yeah, stick your finger. Feel his gums, Dana would say to me. Feel their gums. And by the time I stick my finger in one of my children's mouth, clamp down and bite my finger. Oh, yeah, glory. Woo! That feels good. That's a tooth growing in. Time that second child came around, she said, feel their teeth. Ah, I'm sticking my finger back in that mouth. You survived it. Ear infection. Knowing how to spell Dimetapp or Dimetapp or whatever it's called. Forgetting how to spell your own name. See, it's worth it. You raising your children, being there, it's worth it. God loves you. You're special to him. And I want you to know that it's worth it. Let me just break Deborah down in this text that we read. Because this is not some superwoman. This is a regular mother who juggled her profession. And I just imagine she had plenty of days where she just felt like giving up. So in Judges chapter 4, there are four things I want to talk about very quickly. Number one, you got to remember Deborah, first of all, is a prophetess. She's a mouthpiece of God for God's chosen people. She's a mouthpiece of God in Israel, just like Isaiah was, just like Jeremiah was. God spoke to her, God spoke through her, and he gave her his word. Verse 6 says she goes to Barak, and Barak, a military man, is taking direction from a woman. Now, you know that's difficult. That still stings the pride today, you men, that when your wife is right, amen. Doesn't bother me. As long as we get it right is all I care about. Amen. Ronnie, you better pull over and get some gas. Oh, we can make it another 30 miles. 2 miles up the road, we're sitting on the side of the road. Now I got to hear, I told you so. Told you so. I said, how are we going to get from here? She said, you got to walk back to the gas station I told you to stop at. So what are you saying? You got to get it right. So she speaks to this man. He's a military man. And why did God speak to a woman? Why did he use a lady to speak for him? The Bible said the Lord, the God of Israel, commands you. That's what she told him. But why a woman? I want to ask, why not a woman? Why not a woman? She didn't have to be overqualified to lead Israel, especially if you go back and read what some of the leaders, how they were qualified. Some of the men were doing a pretty poor job. I think we need more women in leadership. I said, I think we need more women in leadership. He chose to use this woman not only to bless Israel, but to tell women everywhere that you can serve, ladies. You can have a place of ministry. You can serve in leadership. God's got a purpose for you. God's got a plan for you. Just because bad things happen to you and you got to suck it up, buttercup, and you got to do the role of a man and a woman, hey, God's favor is on you. God's got a purpose for you. He'll open doors of ministry to you. That's a big job being a prophetess. It's time consuming. But that's not all she did. Second of all, she's a judge of Israel. You keep reading your Bible, verses 4 and 5. Judges is the story of Israel in a time when God used judges to lead Israel, to give them the word of God, and to remind the people of their commitment to God. He used judges. And he had some interesting judges, but Deborah, I believe, is the most interesting. Why? Because at this point in time, he's using a woman to judge Israel at the time of war. The Hebrew word judge means to pronounce sentence, to vindicate or to punish, to judge, deliver, or rule. And you go back and read the first three verses of that chapter, you find Israel's in a mess. Israel's in a mess. And if you've got a mess in the house, who's better to clean it up than a woman? Amen. See, Dana can clean the house better than I can. I know she can. I know she can. Because I tell her, you go on, and I'm going to keep the house clean. And there's a difference how I learned to keep it Marine Corps clean, and now my definition of clean is two different definitions. And Dana says, I'm going out of town to go see Daddy or whatever. And I said, that's fine. House is going to be clean. And when it comes back, there's only 12 or 13 loads of clothes. There's only a couple of loads of dishes in the sink. You know, and my definition of clean is put a towel over the sink dishes. It's clean. Dana can out-clean me. She can outwork me in that regard. And so you've got to understand that when she was helping Israel in this time, Israel's in a mess. They were the captives of Jabin. They had been oppressed by Sisera for 20 years. And so when Israel cries out for help, God sent a woman. God sent a woman when they cried out for help. She holds court in the country of Ephraim. And the Israelites, the Bible said, came to her to settle their disputes. She's the one that God gave answers to. And notice what she said to this man. He said, I'm not going out to fight that army unless you go with me. Verse 8, and if you go with me, I'll go, but if you don't go, I'm not going to go. This is a woman of integrity. Apparently, he knew her. Apparently, he knew that she was favored of God, because not many men instinctively ask a lady to go to battle with them. If my wife is in danger, it's just instinctive to me to stand up and to put another man in his place. You hear me? You don't mess with my wife. You don't mess with my children. You don't mess with her children if I'm not around, because Mama Bear will come out at that time. Amen. 5-foot grizzly. Praise God. Amen. Amen. And so he says, I'm going to go if you go. If you don't go, I'm not going to go. So apparently he has confidence with her. It wasn't necessary for her to go. It just showed incredible leadership and confidence that he had in Deborah. He is putting his trust in God's woman, who is God's leader. She's a prophetess. She's a judge. She's got a tough job. I mean, these two things on her plate are tough enough as it is. But watch this. Not only is she a prophetess, not only is she a judge, she's also a wife. Amen. She's the wife of Lapidoth. Deborah, she's married. She's a judge, she's a prophetess, and now she's a wife. Now, I don't know how it went, but I know how it is in real life today. Lapidoth comes home, old Lappy. He comes home from work. He's tired. He's been out working in the garden. He's been tilling it up, plowing the field. He's come home. He's dirty. He's tired. He's been out in the sun, and she's just as tired. She'd been washing and cooking and cleaning and ironing and going after the kids and chasing them around. And don't you run from me, don't you run from me, and don't you run from me. And she's running after them saying, don't you run from me. Whoever invented that string thing where you tie the kids with a piece of string, amen, and you on the other end of you, that was a brilliant person, had to be a woman. Watch this. She's a wife. He comes home. Old Lappy comes home and says, hey, Deb, what we got for supper? She says, well, we're going to have chicken nuggets and french fries. What do you mean chicken nuggets and french fries? We've had that two times this week. She said, shut up, Lappy, and just eat. And you ought to just shut up and eat it, because, you know, make it real. You didn't have to cook the nuggets and you didn't have to cook the french fries. If she brought them to you, you're blessed. Amen. Chicken nuggets and fries again. Why? You know, can't we have something else? Well, how about a hot dog? Well, is it kosher? Where are you going, Deborah? You got another case? Yeah, I've got to run down to Bethel tonight and hear a case. And I can just imagine him saying to her, you know, why are you always gone, Deb? You're putting your job before me and these kids. That sounds familiar, doesn't it? You know, you think about it. You think about it. If this woman is a prophetess, she's a judge, she's a wife. Before there was an iPod, before there was an iPad, before there was an iPhone, before there were even telephones, they were just screaming from one house, part of the house, to the other part. We don't even scream. See, when Dana and I first got married, Jimmy, we didn't call. We didn't, if we had a telephone, we didn't have two separate lines. We did. I would be in the back of the house, and Dana would be in the front part of the house, and I'd holler, "Hey, Dana!" And she'd scream just as loud as me, "What do you want? Quit screaming!" And I'd say, "I got to scream for you to hear me." And she'd scream back, "If you wasn't so lazy, you could get up and come in here and talk to me." And I'd holler back, "If you wasn't so lazy, you'd come back here and find out what I wanted." And that's how we talk to each other. Before we had cell phones, now we don't even holler. We just send text to everybody. I'm in the bedroom, and Dana's in the living room. I send her a text, "Yo." And she'll say, "What?" She don't even have, I mean, she, you know, she ain't got, she's not down. "Yo, what?" I said, "Bring me a Coca-Cola. Get up and fix it yourself." And so I just gag and cough a little bit more, and she feels bad for me, so she'll bring me a Coca-Cola. Before the laptop and Facebook and Kraft that invented the macaroni that tastes like plastic when you put the orange stuff on it. Before the washboard and Tide, and before the Kenmore washer and the Maytag repairman, Deborah's juggling the role of prophetess, judge, and a wife. Man, she's got her plate full. She's a working mom with a husband. How'd she do it? I don't know, but I figure you moms here today have a pretty good idea. Amen. Amen. Not only that, not only is she a prophetess, a judge, and a wife, watch this. Number four, she's a mom. Verses 5-7, she's a mother. Look at her song, Deborah's song. "Until I, Deborah, arose a mother in Israel." Now here's the clincher. Not only a prophetess, judge, and a wife, but somehow in her hectic schedule, she and old Lappy, they found time to have a family. Now, this is before Gerber. This is before instant oatmeal and instant grit. Listen, I've heard people say over here in Mississippi, we take pride in our grits over here. And no distinguished Southerner would ever eat an instant grit. I love grits, instant or cooked over the water. Amen. Amen. You can't ruin grits. It's just impossible. If you get them too thick, add a little more water, a little more butter until you get it where you want it. Amen. And before that, before the Playtex bottle, before a microwave, I remember before we ever even had a microwave, Dane was just a baby, and she was teaching me how to make the formula in the bottle. And you got that bottle, praise God. And you put that just amount of scoop, about a scoop of that stuff in that stuff. I don't even know what you call that stuff in there. And you gotta let the water run until it's not just too hot or just too cold. It's gotta be just right. And with your hand as a gauge under the faucet. And so I get it in there and I get it too cold. And you know, you put the water in there and you pinch the nipple and you shake it up like that. You shake it up like that. And then you sprinkle it on your wrist. And then, you know, and Dana would take it. It feels good to me. Felt fine to me. Dana sprinkled it on her. She said, "That's too cold. Why didn't you do it?" She'd take it, and she'd put a little hot water in there, add a little bit of that, and she'd get it just right. Before we had all of that, before the pacifier, I don't get it. All the moms over the pacifier. You know, I saw a mother do that not long ago, and the pacifier hit the floor. Oh, my Lord, you'd have thought the world was coming to an end. I learned a long time. Dane, dropped that pacifier, man, we'd pick it up. We'd scald it with hot water. She'd dip it in antibacterial medicine and stuff and wash it off and give it back to him. By the time the second child came around, it hit the floor, and we'd just pick it up and run the hot water over it and give it back to the baby. Time that third and that fourth child got here, man, if it hit the ground, you just stick it in your own mouth and just give it back to him. Praise God. Amen. How many of you men know I'm telling you the truth now? Amen. Little dirt never hurt any child. What do you think they're eating outside when you let them play in the backyard? Those mud cakes, that's not real chocolate. You moms do understand that, don't you? Before disposable diapers, oh, God bless the woman who invented the disposable diapers. I remember before disposable diapers. And I swore when my first child was born, we never knew cloth diapers. Never knew. I still have haunted memories of cloth diapers. I lose sleep every now and then. Thank God for disposable diapers. I remember we had three children at the time, Dane and Jace and Olivia, 11 months apart, and there were three kids. It was Grace. All three of them, Dana was already out of the diaper set, and I would come home from the office, and Dana would be sitting right in the middle of the living room floor, squalling. Look what you did to me. Oh, God's going to get you. And there would be little diapers folded up, laying all in the floor, looked like little mines and bombs going off. Had to watch where you're stepping. Oh, man, you didn't know if it was going to blow up or not. And I honestly never thought we'd ever get out of the diaper or the milk stage. We were going through 3 and 4 gallons of milk a week and diapers every time we turn around. I could have bought I could have bought investment in Coca-Cola of all the money we spent in diapers. But the reason I'm still here is because she kept it all together. Amen. Why are we having all them diapers in the floor? What are we having for supper? Chicken nuggets and fries. You just learned it? Yeah, amen, baby. If you cook it, amen. Before the baby wipe and hot and cold running water, the diaper bag and training pants and potty chairs, and before daycare and babysitters and high chairs and strollers, before all of those things, Deborah was a working mom. You know, it made me wonder, did God speak to her when the kids were screaming? He had to have. You know, one of the things that our children, when if Danny was gone, I just kept my kids. That's just something I did. Hey, I love keeping my kids. I've got a history of raising my children, too. I love it. But, Paul, I mean, my grandmother would tell me stories. We'd go to town, and I'd just load my kids up. Come on, kids, let's go to town. And my grandmother would say, my grandfather, she said, my Lord, little Ronnie, Price Smith wouldn't take his kids down to the end of the driveway to the mailbox. And I'm thinking, I'm so glad that I love my kids. And one year we were going to Hattiesburg, and we were living in Harrison. And all of my kids, two of them were still in diapers, and Dane was the oldest child. And we left Harrison, Arkansas, drove to Hattiesburg, well, actually Long Beach, where we went to the ocean. And I took all of my kids. Man, I could stop that truck, change a diaper. Hey, amen. I learned one valuable trick, though. Man, get them some of that cough medicine, put them to sleep. Hey, amen. They sleep 9-10 hours. Praise God. I'd put Shambach on the radio. Me and Shambach have church for 9 hours all the way up. My kids finally wake up. We get to, they'd walk out like they'd been on drugs. Ooh. They'd wake up every now and then. Why am I such a good father? Because I had a good wife to help me. Deborah, I'm sure took her kids to work. I'm sure she probably wanted to scream and pull her hair out. Any of you mothers do probably on any given day. Amen. But there's nothing in the text that said that she was not an excellent wife or a top-notch mom. Everything indicates that she was. I'm sure she got tired. I'm sure she was frustrated, but she held it all together. She loved her husband, loved her kids. And here's the greatest epitaph connected to her, the last verse of the fifth chapter of Judges. Because of this woman, watch this, Israel had peace for 40 years. Wouldn't it be awesome if we could just find any leader that America could enter into a land of peace for 40 years? This woman brought peace to Israel for 40 years. So there's no question to her role in Israel. Philip had seven daughters in the New Testament who the Bible said they were prophetesses. And we read of at least two more prophetesses in the Old Testament, Miriam and Huldah. And you're saying here, well, Pastor, I'm a mom. I can't do all of these things. Yes, you can. Deborah did. Deborah's your model. See, God's got a ministry for you, ladies. And we've got plenty of ladies around here that'll help you with those kids. I tell Daniel and Casey all the time, bring those kids over to my house. It's like they're scared to bring their kids over to my house. Oh, you don't know what you're really asking for, Pastor. Yeah, I do. I've seen them around here. They're all right at my house. Wyatt, Michaela, all these kids. Ethan, come to my house. Amen. Every time I turn around, Dana's got some more kids in my house. And Ethan was over there just last Sunday. He comes to my house. Where's Ethan at? Ethan, where you at? Come here, son. Come here. Where's Wyatt? Wyatt, Michaela? He asleep? Come here, Michaela, Sue. That's not her name. I just want I give her, Michaela. I'm closing. These kids come to my house. You know what we do? First thing we do, all these kids, any of your kids, you bring all these kids to my house. Amen. They can have anything but my hot dogs. They can drink my soda. They can leave my hot dogs alone. But when they come to my house, first thing I do is connect them to the Wi-Fi. You know why? Because that's part of their life. Sister Dana's always asking these kids, what y'all want? Can I have this? You know, one thing, one rule in my house, if there's food in my house, you don't ask for it. You just go get it. Just go get it, except my hot dogs. If there are Twinkies in the cabinet, go get them. If you don't, better you'd eat them than me. If they're in there, I eat them. Banana Twins, that's my thing, man. Love me some Banana Twins. And these kids come to my house, and Dana is like a mother to them. Bring those kids to my house. Bring Gavin and Garrett over those house. Why? Why come over? Pastor Ron, he don't even have to ask. I just give him my phone. He wants to play a game. Why? Because moms, you're raising your kid by yourself. You've done a great job. You need some help from time to time. And I look around here, I see Casey. I see Jeannie. I see all of you, Connie. I see all of you, Jan. And she, all you, Alicia. I see all you ladies. Destiny, she's got two of her own. She don't need no more right now. Then he's saying, keep your kids to yourself. Amen. I got my own. I asked Destiny this morning, where's Dawson? Dawson coming to church? She said, I don't know. She's in trouble because she didn't bring my buddy. Because sometimes your plate is so full that you just need some encouragement. You just need some help. If Deborah could do it, you can do it. She was a prophetess. She was a judge. She was a wife. She's a mother. Moms, the fact that you're still sitting here today testifies to how strong you really are. And you've raised your kid. Misty, I'm glad you're raising this girl. Now, if Pastor Wendell was raising this girl, she'd be a good girl. But she'd be driving Jeeps all the time. Amen. With a 9mm on her side. I'm glad she... And I'm glad you're raising a young man that knows how to be respectful. Amen. Thank you, kids. Stand with me, church. Amen. I know I went long. I just wanted to tell you, Deborah is your example. That God's got ministry doors for you. And these kids that are in this room, and all you mothers that are here, and all the ladies that are not mothers yet, but you're a mother to somebody else's child. I talked to Crystal earlier, her and Persephone. And they said, we're mothers to fur babies. I don't know what a fur baby is. What? Dogs? Oh, dogs. Why didn't they just say dogs? Persephone's got about 4 or 5. Crystal's got about 4 or 5. Amen. Amen. But all of you mothers that have raised your kids, all these other children going around, grab a child, hug them, and help that mother. Be a word of encouragement to them. Bless them. Amen. Father, I love you this morning, and I thank you for an opportunity just to take a different day and dedicate this to the mothers. And so many times, mothers are being raked over the coals and telling how to be a better mom. But you know, Lord, you blessed us with some tremendous wives. You blessed us that women that raise our kids while we're at work. It hadn't been easy. It hasn't been easy. But Lord, you strengthened our wives and our mothers. And this is my first Sunday without my mother. So let me just speak to your heart for just a moment. Because I've been guilty of not calling my mother on Mother's Day in times past. Not picking up the phone and calling her. I'd go a week without just saying hello. So today, moms, you got your children. Listen to me, children. Tell your mom you love her. Appreciate your mother today. And for all of you that still have your mothers alive, my mother-in-law, she'll get a phone call. My father-in-law, he'll get a phone call. Call your mother. Hug them. Kiss them. Love them. Tell them you appreciate them. How much you respect them. Because if the Lord tarries, life continues to be life. And we're all going to die one day. That's just a fact. But I believe the Lord's coming soon. And I sure would love to see my mother tomorrow by way of the rapture. And all of my children go to heaven with me. But today, call your parents. Call your mom. Say, I love you, Mom. Robin? Where's Robin Bennett? There you are. Go cut Daddy's hair, I guess. Robin, she said, Daddy's mad at me, Pastor, because I cut your hair more than I cut my daddy's. I guess you need to go cut your daddy and your mama's hair. Amen. I appreciate your parent today. I know it's different sermon, different type of message, different day. It was structured to be this way. I want to tell all the mothers. Can I see all the mothers raise your hand for just a... If you've not gotten a mug, a coffee mug in the back, get one, please. But I want me to say from this pulpit, say how much I love you and I appreciate you. You get the word out. Faith Assembly appreciates women. We love our ladies. Amen. Did the word help anybody today? Did you get something from the Lord? Are you blessed? Amen. Then join hands with the person next to you. We're going to pray. I'll let you go. I know you've got a busy day. Father, for every person in this room today, I thank you for bringing them here to worship with us today. Pray, Lord, that your word strengthened and encouraged them. Moms are busy people. So many times they're overwhelmed. But today I ask for rest and peace and strength, good fellowship, word of encouragement from their children. And I ask you, Lord, to bless the mothers today, every day, but today specifically. Bless them. Let them know that you're near. And I thank you for this day that you've given me an opportunity just to encourage the ladies and tell them that from the leadership of this church, we love and appreciate them. I give you praise and glory in the wonderful name of Jesus. And all the ladies said out loud, I'm blessed. Amen. Don't forget Wednesday night. Somebody's going to be here. Somebody's going to be here.
Tomorrow night, ladies, if you have small children, go ahead and come. Miss Pam will be here to watch them where you can enjoy the night as well.
And listen, men, Brother David, Brother Chris, Brother Daniel, Pastor Cody, Brother David, all you men, Brother Edward, all you men, we're going to cook. You young men better learn how to do this too. We're going to cook. We're going to wait on the ladies. We're going to serve them. Amen. And then next month, they're going to do it for us too. Praise God. I love you. 7 o'clock tomorrow night, men, we need you here. Please come and help us. Amen. Have a great day, moms. We love you.